Big Cat Rescue Operant Conditioning Class. Big Cat Rescue's animal training program is based on operant conditioning. Operant conditioning is a type of learning in which behaviors are altered by the consequences that follow them. The behaviors are not forced, but caught, reinforced, and therefore trained. We train only natural behaviors, no entertainment types of behaviors. Operant conditioning can reduce the stress loads imposed by captivity, enhance keeper safety, facilitate routine care, improve animal welfare, enrich the animal and volunteer experience. Big Cat Rescue's operant training program is intended for eliciting calm behavior from each of our animals while they are in the presence of their keepers and the veterinary staff, training behaviors that are dependable regardless of the trainer's presence, providing mental stimulation for our animals, enabling safe emergency and non-emergency transportation of the animals, and providing public education. Levels of training. Big Cat Rescue's operant training program is broken into three certification levels. Volunteers and interns are eligible to become certified to participate in operant conditioning with the animals they are certified to feed. The three levels are small cats, Big Cats Level 1, cougars and leopards, Big Cats Level 2, lions and tigers. A senior or master keeper or level 5 intern must have acquired 6 months of training in both big cat feeding and green level cougar and leopard operant training prior to being permitted to train Chitaro the leopard. Veterinary care training. Level 5 interns, senior keepers, master keepers, and veterinarians will be participating in veterinary care training. This training includes, but not limited to, working with animals in the cat hospital or in quarantine, desensitizing animals to topical sprays, training target behaviors for specific veterinary procedures, working with veterinary care staff, training and observing yellow level trainers, and evaluating the animals and trainers' progress. General guidelines. Always check with the coordinator prior to planning a session. Training sessions should be well planned out before starting. Training sessions should be logged on the operant site on the .me site. Training sessions should be short. If an animal acts aggressively towards any trainer, it is the trainer's responsibility to discontinue working with that animal and to report the incident to the coordinator. Use only approved verbal signals and hand signals.
Yeah.
No is never to be used during training sessions. Never draw attention to errors. Ignore what you don't want and reward what you want. If the animal is not cooperating, step back and reset, then resume training. Do not repeat commands. Say it once and be patient. Training sessions should be done with a partner as often as possible. This will allow the animals to be accustomed to more than one person during the training sessions. This will also allow the other person to observe and to give their input on the session. If there is more than one animal in a cage, two trainers must be present, or the animals must be separated without causing stress. Training sessions should take place when the environmental conditions are most favorable. Training sessions are not recommended in the rain or the heat of the day. Avoid food reinforcement immediately after feeding time. However, training sessions shortly before feeding time can be most productive. Anytime we are feeding, interacting, cleaning, giving tours, etc., we need to keep in mind that we are affecting how the animal interacts with us. Do not ever reward or reinforce bad behaviors. We will need to work together as a team for this program to work. Everyone will get to train animals they really like, but we need to make sure that the animals' needs come before our needs. Training program. Ideally, we would like to have all animals and eligible keepers participating in helping us achieve the goal of the operant training program. That goal is to make feeding and caring for the animals, including observations, medical exams, and vet procedures as safe and efficient as possible. This program is designed with the animals and sanctuary's needs in mind. This is a very strict program that requires a lot of dedication and work to ensure success. Trainers should be prepared to commit a minimum of 2 days per week to participating in this program. Training commands. Please use only the commands listed below. These are the approved commands that we will need for general husbandry. Calling animal to side of cage. Animal. Animal comes to the side of the cage and takes reward off the stick without swatting, stick biting, or any part of their body out of the cage. The goal is for the animal to stay with you and not get anxious or walk away until you are finished rewarding. Trainer. Trainer will use operant stick to deliver reward. Down. Animal. Animal should have all 4 feet on the ground inside the cage, crouched so belly and chest is on the ground. Animal should be sternal. Trainer. Verbal command down, simultaneous with the flat palm moving down. At the same time, the trainer drops to one knee. Fingers should be closed, as with all hand signals, hands should be well away from the cage and out of reach of the animal. Yeah. Lockout. Animal. Animal should have all 4 feet in the lockout and remain until given several treats or another command. Running in and grabbing a treat and running out is progress towards, but not considered lockout. Trainer. Verbal command given while pointing or walking towards lockout.
Lockout. So watching out is
T-shift. Closing animal in lockout. 2 trainer minimum, at least 1 trainer must be certified green level trainer. Animal. Animal comes into lockout, stays calm while lockout door is shut. Trainer. 1 trainer focused on the animal, 1 trainer closing the lockout door. Make sure that when closing the lockout door, the door is lowered slowly and safely so no animal's extremities are closed in the door. This is the appropriate size meat for a small, medium, and large cat. Be sure to adhere to dietary restrictions and special needs when choosing a type and size of meat for your operant session.